The queen honeybee is the single most important bee in the honeybee colony. Her name is a bit of a misnomer because the word queen implies that she's making decisions on behalf of her subjects in the nest, that she's ruling with an iron scepter, that she's the one who's advancing the colony. And really, those things aren't true. The queen is the egg layer in the nest. She's the mother of all the bees in the nest, but she doesn't tell the bees what to do. She doesn't rule the bees. Actually, those group decisions are made by the workers. The queen, on the other hand, has the sole task of laying eggs. Let's talk about this queen, this mother of all the bees in the nest. Queen honeybees are female, but they derive from the same eggs that workers derive from. Remember, queens could have been workers, workers could have been queen, and all is dictated by the amount of diet that the individual female larva is receiving as she ages. Queens get lots of high quality diet, we call that royal jelly, from a very young larval age through their larval development. In fact, queens develop from egg to adult in 16 days in wax cells that we call queen cells. These cells hang vertically from combs in the nest. When the adult queen emerges from her cell, she's still a virgin. She needs to go on mating flights. Typically, beekeepers will refer to this stage of adult queen development as the virgin queen stage. Usually somewhere in the neighborhood of about 2 weeks, this virgin queen will go out on a mating flight, mate with multiple drones, store the semen from all of these drones in a special organ she has in her abdomen called the spermatheca. She flies back to the nest and from that point forward lays eggs, deciding whether or not to fertilize those eggs and produce female offspring or keep those eggs unfertilized to produce male offspring. Because of this egg-laying job or task that the queen has, she has two very large ovaries in her abdomen that makes her abdomen larger than that of the workers. And this queen, as she's deciding to lay eggs, she'll put her head in the individual cells. She'll measure the diameter of those cells to determine what type of cell can receive the egg that she wants to lay. If it's a certain type of cell, a larger cell with a larger diameter, it's destined to house a drone egg. She'll lay an unfertilized egg. If it's a smaller cell, it's destined to house a worker egg, so she'll lay a female egg. So from that point forward, for the rest of her life, the queen will stick her head into cells, determine the readiness of that cell to receive an egg, determine what type of egg needs to go into that cell, back her abdomen into that cell, and deposit that egg. That's what the queen spends her life doing. In fact, in peak egg laying season, the queen may lay 2,000 eggs a day. Beyond that, a queen may lay 500,000 or more eggs in her entire lifetime. Queen honeybees can live 2 years, 3 years, or more, but the average queen honeybee usually lives somewhere in the neighborhood of about a year to 18 months. Queens are usually replaced during swarming season. The old queen will leave with the swarm and a new one will take her place. Beyond simply laying eggs, queens have another very important function in the nest. You see, they're not just egg layers. They are maintainers, maybe promoters of colony homeostasis. What does this mean? Well, queens produce pheromones, these chemicals that come from their bodies that help control the behavior and the intent of the colony and the bees that compose it. So as a queen is producing these pheromones, the worker bees in the nest recognize that they have a queen. When they recognize that they have a queen, they will do things that they do when queens are present. For example, they will forage, they will want to collect nectar, they will want to collect pollen because they know this queen is producing offspring and there's a great demand for nectar and pollen for the offspring. They'll build comb. The workers, females themselves, will forego laying eggs because they can detect a queen is present. Simply having a queen in the nest causes bees to do what they should do when everything is going well. Remove that queen from the nest, and the workers in the nest then have this cascade of behaviors to try to replace that queen and return that colony to homeostasis. So queens lay eggs, they promote colony homeostasis. They are the single most important bee in the nest. One of the most fascinating things about them, though, is just with the flip of a diet, they could have been a worker. They could have had that whole cascade of behaviors that workers are known for having, but they don't because they're queens. They got fed a lot, they went on mating flights, they lay eggs, and because of that, we have healthy, strong colonies. Interestingly, in the beekeeping world, there's a whole contingency of beekeepers who produce queens. They breed certain queens for certain traits for beekeeping operations. Maybe high productivity, maybe high gentleness. Maybe they want certain hygienic traits or other traits that confer resistance or tolerance to certain diseases and pests. All of this starts with the quality of the queen, the individual in that nest who is solely responsible for populating the whole nest and whose presence makes that colony move forward in unison.